Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. You've clicked on or stumbled across Gotham Cenobites. I'm Terry, and I want to get right into this one. I'm very excited. This is the first guest review, first of many, thanks to our guest. I don't want to waste too much of your time. I want to get right into this one, so here it comes.
Everybody, Demetrius here, aka The Incredible Him, back with another XM Studios Dark Knights metal piece. Behind me we have Murder Machine. I'm actually getting ready to box it up, and I'll talk about why I'm boxing it up in a bit, but first I want to shout out Terry over at Gotham Cenobites. Genuinely appreciate you, man, and this is gonna be good. Let's jump right in. All right, here we have it, XM Studios Dark Knights metal Murder Machine. First, I'm gonna start with the plaque, right? I absolutely love these things. Any opportunity that I get, especially for a piece that I know I really want, I'm going to make the pre-order day one so that I can ensure the highest chances of picking one of these up. I love the fact that they do this and they transition from the coin to these plaques. I mean, it's genuinely special, right? So, I'm sure most of you probably want to know why I'm going to go ahead and box this beauty up. And so some of you probably have already pointed it out or noticed it. It's going to be this here. So I've seen this on a few other people's pieces. Unfortunately, this left leg is just not going flush. I'm not sure. Well, to be honest, it seems as if the peg on the right leg is warped. I mean, it could be multiple reasons, but I'm getting ready to box it up to go ahead and try to have that repaired and explore some options around it. I would say that that's the biggest disappointment for me. I genuinely dislike that. It's let's get a bit more angle on that. I mean, look at that. You just wouldn't expect this sort of flaw from XM. I personally hold XM as number one for quarter scale pieces. I own quarter scale pieces from Sideshow XM, Iron Studios, a bunch of custom pieces, right? I mean, this is just unacceptable, XM. I don't understand it. I own over 20 XM pieces as well, and I don't have any of them that have this sort of issue. Hey, let's talk about the piece, right? Let's start at the bottom. So you have this this awesome base, bat symbol, or bat signal, rather. It looks like Murder Machine is more or less materializing from underneath it with these wave-like nanoparticles, nanobites, nanotech, right? Whatever you want to call it, it's ridiculous. I love the fact that XM is so ambitious in the way that they handle these sorts of things, from the way that they handle flame to, I mean, come on, this is ridiculous. And it's extremely durable and solid, right? So let's take a look in here. I would say that there's a pretty big difference in the base. Well, maybe not that big, but there's a difference in the base between this production piece and, let's say, the Batman statue collector's prototype, right? So for example, this lip here is a lot shorter on the production piece, whereas in the prototype and in the solicitations, it was a lot longer. It was maybe came up to here. And that may be why this leg doesn't slide in. I mean, it just catches here. Let me give you more better view on that. I mean, it just really gets caught by that. Moving up the piece, a lot of detail. I like how there's blue woven in between, you know, the metallic silver,
You have hits of bronze on here. I mean, there's so much going on, right? Let's come up here. You have, this is my favorite configuration. When I saw the piece online, I immediately knew that this is how I would like to display it. You have the red hit up here on the shoulder, right? Going onto the chest plate. Interesting thing about this piece, and something that I really enjoy about it, is this front blade. You can actually switch it to the back, right? So you can put this in the front or the back of the piece, or rather the right and left arm sockets. It will take it both ways. Absolutely incredible piece. It still has a lot of presence. I mean, even with the flaw there on the left leg, not connecting, not going flush, it still is incredible, especially alongside the other Dark Knights metal pieces, right? So for those of you who are unaware, I also own the Batman Who Laughs and the Merciless version B. So go check out the Batman Who Laughs commentary or comparison. All right, let's jump into the rear, right? We're gonna start at the very bottom. There's a lot of detail. I mean, XM does extremely well with their paint app. I mean, look at this. The gravel transitioning into the brown, dirty look with the nanobites coming up. You have on the broken bat symbol, there's a lot of detail, right? You have the anchor for the piece, or for the symbol, more or less being ripped over or maneuvered by the nanoparticles, right? On the back of Batman, I mean, wow, look at that. The paint app is ridiculous. The detail is ridiculous. All of the different colors, the blue in there, the bronze, the red, as it kind of contrasts the charcoal or the steel look, right? You have these joints on the elbow, right? The shoulder, another one here. There's a lot of detail on the back of Batman's, I don't know if this even, it could be called a cowl anymore, considering the fact that he is no longer human, right? And he's merged with this nanotech, and this arm is, look at that. Insane. I always applaud XM for being ambitious, right? I mean, to send this, right? This is one piece by itself. There's a nice cavity within the shipper or the styro. So it did well, but it could have easily gone wrong. In fact, the left shoulder pad there had actually arrived broken off, so I had to fix that. But it was a clean break, so no worries. Absolutely love this piece. I'm just hoping that we can address this issue down here, as you can see. I also feel like the nanoparticles in the wave formation that they're in, it just provides such a dynamic look. Like he's just emerged and formulated or formed from the nanoparticles. Great concept. All right, last but not least, let's talk about the light up feature. So as you can see, the eyes are lit. Amazing, right? The chest symbol is lit as well. Now at night, this is absolute stunner. In the dark, especially next to the other Dark Knights metal pieces, I mean, wow. Kudos to XM for including the feature. I genuinely appreciate it. I'm one of those collectors that loves a light up feature, especially one that complements a piece just like this does. Let's take a look at the battery cavity. It's gonna be right here in his neck. All right. So this can kind of be a pain if you're looking to get this piece and you want to put the batteries in. If you have kind of stubby fingers like myself, it's going to be tough to get them in. But once you do, you should be all set, right? This is the portrait, right? Open cavity style. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that back on there. Just looking at this, I don't even want to box it up. You know, but we have to take a chance at trying to get this fixed. Again, I keep coming back to that. And it, you know, as a collector, I've been doing this over 10 years. I'm not affected as much as I would have been in my early days by the flaw. but it definitely, it's still in the back of my mind. So I have to do my due diligence to try to take care of that. Last remark on this, I thought about this piece a lot. I thought it was a kind of a sleeper, especially in the lineup. I think between this one and the Devastator, those, they were my least favorite, but this one has definitely jumped up in regards to my perception of it. And so it kind of gives me hope for the Devastator piece as well. I have that one on pre-order. I pretty much have the majority of the Dark Knight's metal and death metal pieces from XM. Also, in terms of, I own the Prime 1 Cyborg, the quarter scale Cyborg. So I would love to see these two next to each other or kind of facing off because they have similar poses. If any of you have seen the Prime 1 Cyborg. Even originally, I was wondering if it would be redundant to have both of them, but they are starkly different pieces. I can't say enough good things about this. Again, just got to keep coming back to this, though, right? All right, guys. I appreciate you all. Thank you so much, and happy collecting.
All right, and there it is. XM's Murder Machine. Thank you to Demetrius. I want to say big shout out to you. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to review a statue for the channel. I really appreciate it. I also appreciate the way you're able to articulate these things, really break it down and able to convey your feelings with such intelligent words. Something I struggle with. I hate hearing my voice describing statues, so that's why I usually just dub music over it. But it's really nice to not only see this piece, but actually hear you articulate it, to hear you break it down and what you think of it. So yeah, thank you so much for that review. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. I did want to kind of give you one more update, which is kind of what's taken me so long to get this video put together and out for you guys, is he did have it repaired, and at some point I'm going to put the picture up in front of my face, but without calling out the distributor that he went through, because again, this type of problem has nothing to do with a distributor. They're well known though, and the person he had fix it is also well known in the community, and I'm sure the picture that I'm going to put up, you've actually seen on their page. He does great work. I would trust him with any repair or repaints that I could think of. He's great, and it's nice to see at the end of the day, this big problem with this great piece actually got sorted out and got fixed, and I'm happy for you, Demetrius, and I'm happy to see your XM collection with these metal pieces coming along. He did want me to also pass it on to you guys that his final rating is an 8 out of 10. Probably would have been perfect without that flaw, but and I know it's fixed now, but I can definitely relate to having to first, you know, freak out, shell shocked, but then actually go through the extra steps to get the statue fixed. I definitely could understand dropping the rating. So his final is 8 out of 10, and I'm going to agree. I may not ever see these statues in person, but it is nice. But I am going to have the Prime ones, and I will definitely delve into more of Murder Machine's actual backstory once I review the Prime 1 version. But it's a wonderful universe. Great book. I can't believe I didn't already have it over here ready to go. But here it is. DC's Dark Knight's Metal Omnibus. And it's all still sealed. I've read most of it. I am going to open it and read it soon. But if you see his one-off, and I don't have it out yet. It's still in the closet because I don't have the statue yet. But the cover of Murder Machine, he's so like small. Like, it's a whole huge comic cover, and he's like this big. And I'll put that up here, too. But as you see on the back of this, it's finally right here. Pretty good picture of the Murder Machine. But for anybody who watches my stuff, whether you're a friend or not, just passing through for the horror stuff, If you like horror stuff and you like Batman, I implore you, check this book out. It's definitely not your run-of-the-mill Batman story. It's great. I think anybody who's a Batman fan or even, you know, a soft horror fan would enjoy reading this book, and it's all in one place now. I still have yet to read Death Metal, and I may just wait. This is here, so I'm sure the Death Metal Omni's coming, right? But yeah, there it is. Death Metal Omnibus. Go out and get it. And that is going to put a bow on this review. Once again, thank you so much, Demetrius. And more to come. As you saw in the picture, he already has a Merciless version B. I don't know when that's going to come, but he is going to film a review for us for that one, too. And pretty much every metal or death metal piece that XM is bringing. So far, I think the only one he's passed on is the new Superman, which I don't blame him. I mean, not really a Supes guy myself. But every other metal and death metal piece I believe XM has released, he's pre-ordered it. Again, with the Merciless version B, and then I think he also got the version B of Red Death, so the Goldberry version. So that is what is to come from our friend Demetrius, the Incredible Him. Thank you so much. And if you guys enjoyed this video, please consider hitting the like button. Subscribe if you want to for more of this type of content. And let me know in the comment section what you think of this guy. I know it's the only one that we haven't seen really good pictures of what Prime One's doing, so we really can't compare these two yet. And I know people hate comparing one third to one quarter, but it's a universe I love, so of course I'm going to compare apples to pears or oranges or whatever you want to call it. So far, it's fitting to the story. It's a great piece. Congrats again, Demetrius. Thank you so much. And that's going to do it today. Thank you all so much for watching this video. As always, I'll see you on the next one. Take it easy, guys. Peace.